Well, this is Tuesday, and it's Trekland HQ, and looks like we're live. Hey, Plushy McCoy, we are live. And guess what? We're live here with Trekland Tuesdays live, right, man? You've been here 5 years, yes? It's Trekland Tuesdays Live with me, Dr. Trek, Larry Nemecek, and Plushy McCoy. Yes, and Plushy McCoy. And it's a special day because it's not just another Tuesday. It's, well, looky here, looky there. It's our 5th anniversary. Got to show off the fancy logo. It's our 5th anniversary. How about that? How about that, Plushy? Yes!
Well, I'm a doctor, not a celebrator.
I know. I saw the video. Anyway, it's our 5th anniversary. I hope everybody is having a great Tuesday. I'm going to let Plushy take his front row orchestra seat here. A big show, but not a big show at the same time. A couple of surprises, especially for anybody who's been with us just recently. And if you're finding us for the first time, what a day to find us. Make yourself known. Say hi to everybody in the chat because it's kind of a wobbly 5th anniversary. I'm counting the month of May in a couple of days, and I'll tell you why in a minute. I am going to talk. I'll talk about some memories, and then we're going to have an AMA today and ask me anything because, you know, Strange New Worlds is all over the place. It's racking up hits, so we'll see what the YouTube edition looks like this week. If you're watching me later on YouTube, the whole live show is always on the Facebook archive, but who looks at archive Facebook? So it's YouTube, it's cut shorter, but you are more than welcome to join us live some Tuesday because I do this every Tuesday at 1-ish Pacific, 4-ish Eastern, 9-ish UK time, 10-ish Central Europe. Been doing it for 5 years. I know. We had the 250th episode a few weeks back. I want to dive into it. Let's get going because 5 years ago, not this week, I'm splitting it. 5 years ago, the world was changing in Star Trek, and mostly for the better. But the first initial trailers were coming out for Discovery. There was leaked video, there was leaked still footage on some guy, poor guy's Instagram. We need to look that guy up and not lose him to history. He'd been an extra Klingon, and he started the whole Klingon controversy. Everything new that had been changed for Discovery for newness's sake. We now know that was all Brian, so maybe it's a good thing Brian passed. I don't know. Love Brian to pieces. A lot of shaking up kind of ideas, and a lot of his ideas did not get made. That's going to be coming out over the next few years. Some of it's already out, but not on the 24th, but I believe on May 15th, I felt compelled to go live because everybody was saying, Larry, you need to go live, and I went live. Where are we? I went live on my iPhone at the time, holding it up, wobbling a little bit, and this, kiddos, is how it looked.
Hey, everybody. Welcome, Mother and Father Federation and all the ships at space. Welcome from deep inside Portal 47 here at Trekland HQ. No, it's just Larry. Sorry I was a little late there, fumbling around with Facebook Live, all this pioneering stuff, although I know there's plenty of pros out there. I just wanted to jump on today, get some things off my desk. There's a lot going on. I know I've been a little out of it working on Connor Rath, finally editing, and my documentary, ConnorRath.com, and working on Portal 47. But there's some things that have been going on, as usual, online. I talk about them a lot when I get interviewed or on podcasts, like with Chris at the Ready Room on Trek FM. Some of the links are in this post that I made today. But at the same time, it's getting exciting.
It was a blog post and then the video.
Upfronts lately, and then it took a Trek movie to remind me the other day that that's this week, and everybody should be watching for that. At the same time, a lot of the excitement around it is tempered by this good old tendency and good old fandom to the 10% that's just freaking out. Now, I know a lot of this is about people are frustrated and people are passionate. That's what you always say, right? You're passionate. But, I mean, we have history. It's like with everything else. It's like with our current events. We have a history. We can look back at other times. And you know, with Star Trek, it's like, my God, the worst of all was the 10 years we didn't have anything but three flimsy little seasons of reruns trying to get a movie back the first time. Just establish the fact that Star Trek deserved to be back and could actually make some money for the people that need that to happen. But then, yeah, then the times before Next Generation, when it was really a naysayer, the time before The Wrath of Khan, when people actually leaked that Spock was going to be killed off. And did a huge marketing campaign in the era of, oh, look at us, where we are empowering old school network. They're going strike went. Maybe that's why we haven't seen some visuals yet. Or maybe they're saving their fire for the place they'll get the biggest bang for the buck, literally. Two TV specials. 30 now. And of course, if you really enjoy deep diving your background, both day Valley of Fire tour is before. Stay safe, stay woke, and trek well.
Wow, I know. So that's amazing. Number one, we didn't have the opening rigmarole for a few weeks, but I was just trying to calm the waters a little bit there because it seemed insane that people were getting so riled up. Little did I know that that was just what we were in for a few years. But it's amusing to me. I hadn't seen the ending in a long time. There we were talking about a Valley of Fire tour, and I did have the closing. That was 3 years before the pandemic and the George Floyd summer. So I guess I was repping Star Trek to be part of the future, and I didn't know it. Stay well and stay woke and trek well. Here's the thing. That was the first one, and I thought about it. I cogitated for a while about what I should be doing online. And then 2 weeks later, now I skipped a week. So this was actually, I believe it was May 30th. I think it was May 30th. This is why I've got a number one anniversary, but here's what happened on May 30th, 2 weeks later-ish.
Hey, everybody. I know, it's impossible. Welcome to the debut of Trekland Tuesdays with Dr. Trek. Can you see it through the light? There it is. I know, seriously. We will work on our flipping. We will work on all that. But, hey. This is going to be, believe it or not, the beginning of what I hope will be just a few minutes to jump in on Tuesdays and talk about what's been going on, because it seems like we're living in a faster and faster moving world. I know, shock. But even in Star Trek, I mean, we've had 12 years of being in the desert, not used to this pace picking up like it has been, and sometimes I don't know if that's a good thing or not. Case in point, the last week, hard on the heels of the trailer coming out from CBS at the upfronts a couple of weeks ago, you know, within the fandom realm, people debate about All Access, people debate the good, the bad, the canon, the whatever. But I don't know if we were quite ready for this this sidelong sidebar coming in that's now been picked up by the mainstream media. Now, you know, we're used to our little Trek world of media and blogs and everybody following along Star Trek. Discovery upping the game here has brought in all the sci-fi and geek blogs and media and websites. But, you know, We've got the mainstream taking attention here because of this latest news story. And it's all about the, call them what you will. I mean, look, here's my friend Manu writing on The New Yorker, which of course is not going to show up on camera. TheNewYorker.com. For alt-right trolls, Star Trek Discovery is an unsafe place. That's bugged a lot of longtime we are. To what Gene, super nitpicky, over on the mainstream. And we get on to the nitty-gritty of Discovery and everything else about Instagram. And I'll settle in. Larry Nemecek on Facebook. Larry Nemecek's Trekland on Facebook, 7.net, if you enjoy this kind of thing. Guys, we'll see you next week. Hopefully this is going to be a weekly thing. I'll settle in. We'll get this flippy camera thing settled out. No wobble this week. And hey, stay safe, stay woke, and trek well, everybody. See you next week, if not sooner.
Okay. Well, yeah, one step at a time, kiddos. Looking back at these 5 years, One thing at a time, one thing at a time. So I'm glad we got the mute echo there. I'm going to learn this one step at a time, too. Hopefully doing more and more of having some video and clips and things to show in live time. Don't worry. I am not going to give up the shtick of the signs. That's a Trekland Tuesdays live thing now, but we'll see what else we can hit. So no, it's amazing how far we've come since then. And I see everybody putting some questions in. So that's great. And just a reminder that if you're coming to us on Twitch and YouTube, you're seeing all the questions. If you're only on Facebook, which is most people, you're only going to see everybody else on Facebook and not see the Twitch and YouTube questions. So we've got some TTLers who come in on multi-platforms just to handle things and be more adept. It's this last couple of years, you know, the pandemic was, I think, the next big step up. But those early days, and some of you remember, I was reading off my phone. It wasn't on camera because of the crazy thing we had. I was sitting closer back, but I was actually scrolling for questions on my camera face. And that, yes, that led to some issues. And then we had the times of the bad signal, the bad line, the new computer, the new iMac, but the plastic over the air vents, which made the circuits overheat, we finally diagnosed. It's been a learning curve. It's been a fine 5 years. And then came the pandemic. Then came my podcast for 2 years with Dr. Ali. Dr. Ali, who, by the way, just had his little boy on the 17th and told the world a couple of days later. So congrats, Dr. Ali. I think I mentioned that last week. But he and I had Life Support Live for 2 weeks, 2 years during the pandemic. And because of restreaming that, I stepped up and we started finally restreaming, finally started getting Trekland Tuesdays Live easily onto Facebook, onto YouTube, where I could archive it because the world lives on YouTube, not Facebook archives. So it's a wacky world out there. And of course, nobody watches Twitch unless you're going right to Twitch, but hey, it's out there. So I don't know, who's been on today? This is kind of like the class reunion, who came the furthest? who's been with me today that remembers that very first one? Now, the very first one, you know, wasn't branded, wasn't numbered. I retcon branded it next week, but I know by number two that I showed there by the end of May 30th or April 30th. So I was in that April, May time, I'm just declaring now is the anniversary. In that window is when we were actually having the roots. So who goes back with me that far? And however far you go back with me, was there anything I ever said that rang with you? I mean, there are a couple of topics that I'm very proud of. One of them was in the middle of I love being able to say this now because I think it's true, but at the height of the influence, if you want to call it that, of the toxic tubers, I did a topic 1 week called Who Mocks the Mockers? And I was calling for, come on, somebody, where is the, as Will would say, the great common sense, the great normal majority of fandom to counter this insanity, the fake news of Star Trek, and all of pop culture that was trying to divide us by bots, by trolls, by paid people. And whether they were psychotic or just getting paid for it. And I don't think the answer was called due to my call, but within a few months, we started having much saner, more people got online. We started having some early stars. Steve Shrives got out there. It picked up. Folks have come, folks have gone, but I think that ebb and flow has finally passed. Thank God it kind of burned itself out. And of course, the coming of more Star Treks added to that. That was very one. The one, the Russians, robots, and replays was another one that looked at the USC grad student, who I hope has written some more. I'd like to check up on him. I tried to reach out to him, and I think he was maybe gun shy. Thought maybe I was a psycho. Maybe I should try that again. But talked about the actual academic study. Nobody had really done this, I think, since Gamergate, much less through all the Star Wars, and especially our ramp up on Discovery. Tried to analyze how much social media of the negative slice, how small it was. It just felt like it was huge and was depressing everybody. But the fact that you never saw those people in real life was a clue. The fact that they lived online, and then when you started putting some parameters and some academic rigor to it, some protocols, some parameters, and finding out that it was a small slice, but it was a small slice that had doubled, so it did feel noisier. But actually, to get some arms around the numbers, very proud of that one. And those are two that always stand out to me from the earlier days. And it's all available. The full shows are still on Facebook, amazingly. I'm working on, we started with this YouTube replays about a few months after the restream started on YouTube. So there's been nearly 2 years already that are now archived on YouTube. But the first 3 years aren't, aside from some select numbers, at least some of the greatest hits. So I don't know. Yes, we can talk about today. We can talk about strange new. I just have a thing about calling it Strange New Worlds. We can do that. In fact, why don't I do this? Why don't I go ahead and just do the parrots? No, you know what? Let's look at some top questions. Let me see what everybody bopped in with first. It is an AMA. We can talk about, we don't talk about Bruno, but we can talk Cadet Alice. Oh my God, got me so stuck on we don't talk about Bruno. Another Cadet Alice episode is due to come too. After I'm at Phoenix Fan Fusion this weekend, which is the other part of this big week, hoping to see a lot of folks there, but including some Portales and maybe some more TTLers and maybe some lifers. But yeah, I'm just curious if there's any Trekland Tuesday Live memories or thoughts, or if I altered or skewed your thinking about anything in Trek or the business or the history or canon or any of the intersection of any of that. I'm just curious to see, or if I pissed you off royally. I'm up for that too. I'm up for that. This is not vanilla. Although if you're going to have vanilla bean, which is actually a flavor. Thanks everybody. And thanks for your fifth anniversary. Talking about the year of the tour. And by the way, that's finally up on LarryNemecek.com now. All links to all four of these crazy tours. Starting with the one-day Vegas Trek STLV Con Eve that I actually do under the banner for Geek Nation Tours. You can go to geeknationtours.com or you know what? Just come to LarryNemecek.com. There's a master link to everything because not only that, the weekend before is my two-day, all new, not location filming, but locations related to the growing up, youth, childhood, both families, work, life of Gene Roddenberry. Just to tootle around LA and get a vibe for Gene and a vibe for the world that birthed Star Trek. You can go to LarryNemecek.com. If you want to go here and help out, it's a simple thing. I've kept it simple. Just $5, $10, Patreon.com/TreklandLive. You can see all the other Patreons there because I want to thank all these folks, as I do every week. For those, especially these last 2 years that we've been kind of slowly building. But thank you once again, Diane Hopkins. Di, I see you. Robin Wilson, Lawrence Todd, and Marie Siegel, Keith Rombach, Justin Porteous, Nathaniel Robinson, and Blaze K. And yes, our live wires, Rusty Harrell. Thank you, Rusty. Albert Gunn Johnson, Robert McLean. You take care of yourself, Robert. If ER means what I think it means. Hey, Alan Hohansen. J.R. Poole, Byron Bailey, Dave Gregory, Gay Clevin Lindstrom, and Casey Shafsky. You bet. Thank all of you guys for just a little bit that's helping us, you know, add on more and more. Also give a shout out to the Trek Files this week. A new one is up with Oscar-winning, Emmy-winning makeup legend, Mr. Michael Westmore, who I have called for 20 years the nicest guy in Hollywood. He is still sharing his creativity. He's sharing his history and his love of the industry in that nice guy way of his, but honest and blunt as well. Get his book. He's had a book out for a couple of years called Makeup Man. It's Hollywood and Star Trek. And he's still sharing with us this time about the roots, the crash course that was Next Generation makeup. So you want to check it out. Check it out at podcast.roddenberry.com. Of course, the document of the week, because it's the Trek Files and we mean it, is it Facebook, the Trek Files. Pretty simple. And the whole back catalog is there too. Wherever your podcasts are caught, you can find it. Everybody, it's Larry Nemecek on Twitter. It's Larry Nemecek's Trekland on YouTube. Please subscribe over there, like and subscribe it. And Facebook and Instagram as well. Portal47.net. We got Dave tomorrow night for the guest night. It's not too late to jump in. I'll get you in for it. all the monthly package benefits, the round table, the archives, and our live dive. We've got live divers from Portales coming to Phoenix too. What a week. I hope everybody is doing well where you are. It's getting warmer. Watch out for the heat. Watch out for any COVID silliness. Just play it smart. Do all the things. And yes, I am saying, stay healthy out there. Stay woke. Check your sources. Don't get sucked into a troll's bleedings. Check the sources on what you may or may not be hearing. Figure out what's true and not. And you know what? If it turns out that it's true and you hadn't heard it before, once you've checked real news, maybe open your mind to it. But don't be tricked. Don't be fooled by something from somebody that's got one follower that started their account 2 weeks ago. Guess what I'm saying, guys, is wow. Happy 5 years on Trekland Tuesdays Live. Do, 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 do. And trek well, everybody. We'll see you soon.